Precision Polymer Engineering, or PPE for short, manufactures high-performance elastomer O-rings for critical applications around the world. This video shows the complete manufacturing process of how O-rings are made at PPE. The UK manufacturing facility and head office is based in Blackburn, in the northwest of England. The US manufacturing plant is located in Brenham, Texas. The first step in manufacturing an O-ring is selecting the correct mold tool. PPE holds thousands of tools for molding standard-sized O-rings. The smaller sizes are stored in a computerized system, and larger tools stored in racking, all ready to use at a moment's notice. Each O-ring mold is comprised of two halves, a top and bottom. If the O-ring required is a custom size, new mold tools can be manufactured in-house. This greatly reduces the time it takes to get the O-rings into production. The O-ring mold is cut from steel blanks using a high-precision lathe. Correct material selection is key to seal performance. Elastomers derive their performance characteristics from the ingredients and additives that are in them. Fillers, additives, and other ingredients are mixed into the elastomer material using a milling machine. The material is repeatedly passed between two metal rollers to disperse the ingredients evenly. Each material grade is unique, based on the combination and amount of each ingredient used. The elastomer material arrives at the next stage as a sheet, which is cut into strips and inserted into an extruder. Once inside, the material is heated up to reduce its viscosity and forced through a die, which produces lengths of cord. The size of the die aperture is carefully selected based on the finished diameter of the O-ring that's required. During the moulding stage, the cord is cut to size and placed into one half of the heated mould tools, which are fixed to the two platens of the press. When the two halves of the tool close, the elastomer material is moulded into an O-ring shape. It is left in the press for a short length of time to start the curing process. When the press opens, the O-ring is carefully removed from the mould. This technique of manufacturing O-rings is known as compression moulding. Larger O-rings, up to 2.5 meters or 8 foot in diameter, are precision moulded on one of Europe's largest moulding presses at PPE's Blackburn facility. Once moulded, the O-rings often have excess material around the sides, where the two halves of the mould meet. This is known as flash. In the next stage of production, called finishing, this flash can be removed in a number of ways to produce a perfectly round O-ring. Drumming. The O-rings are placed in a drum of rotating stones, which rub the excess flash off. Buffing. Larger O-rings are placed under a buffing wheel. The abrasive action rubs the flash off. Cryo. Small O-rings that are too delicate for any of the other finishing methods are placed in a metal drum. This rotates within a cryogenic environment. Liquid nitrogen cools the elastomer O-rings down until the flash is brittle and can be removed by shot blasting with grit. The deflashed O-rings are placed in ovens to complete the curing process. The length of time they are in the oven depends on the type of elastomer, but typically ranges from 2 hours to 18 hours. Once cooled, the O-rings are now ready for quality inspection. Trained operators use 2x magnification, as stated in the ISO 3601 standard, to visually inspect the O-rings for visual defects. The O-rings are measured using optical non-contact measuring equipment, which accurately checks the dimensions of the finished part. The O-rings are now ready to be packaged as per the customer's requirements. Once bagged and labelled, the O-rings are packaged by the dispatch team, ready to be shipped around the world. So, now you know how O-rings are made at PPE, and why our O-rings are trusted to provide the highest quality and optimal performance for critical applications. To find out more, visit our website at prepol.com.